variance of a random variable variance. Okay, so suppose the mean of a variable capital X is mu. Suppose the mean of a random variable capital X is mu. The variance of the random variable capital X is defined as expectation of x minus mu whole squared, expectation of x minus mu whole squared. What is mu? Mu is the mean, x minus mu. So what will x minus mu? That will be the deviation of the observation from its mean, and we are finding the square, then we are finding the average values of that square. So defined as expectation of x minus mu whole squared, and is denoted by v of x, or in some books we may find this kind of notation var x. So therefore what we are getting, v of x is equal to expectation of x minus mu whole squared. Expectation of expected value means the average value, x minus mu whole squared. Expectation of x minus mu whole squared. So that's the how to find the variance of a random variable capital X. So what is the physical significance of that variance? It will give you the, if it give you the information how the data are spread about its mean. Okay, that is, if the variance is less, that is the observations or data are more close to the mean of the random variable, and if the variance is more, it will be widely spread. So defined by v of x, or variance of x, v of x equal to expectation of x minus mu whole squared. Now this variance sometimes can be written as expectation of x squared. If we open the bracket, what will get? 2 mu x plus mu squared. 2 mu x mu squared. So this is expectation of x squared using the linearity property of, now mean is a constant, so that is 2i's mu into expectation of x plus expectation of mu squared, that will get. Now last class we saw what is expectation of x. Expectation of x actually the mean of the distribution, and last class I think I forgot to define that. If we find expectation of a constant, expectation of c, you will get back same constant. Expectation of c is equal to c, where c is a constant. If c is a constant, C is a constant. Okay, so if you use that, that will give you expectation of x squared minus twice mu. Expectation of x is the mean of x, and we denoted that by mu, plus expectation mu is a constant, mu squared is also constant. So expectation of a constant, we will get back the same constant, that will be mu squared. So if you simplify that, it will give you expectation of x squared minus mu squared. So that can be written as expectation of x squared minus mu is expectation of x whole squared. So that's the variance of a random variable capital X. Variance of x is equal to expectation of x squared minus expectation of x whole squared. Now we'll define an important quantity, that is standard deviation. What is standard deviation? The positive square root of variance is known as standard deviation. Standard deviation, and it is denoted by sigma, or sometimes sigma x. X means the random variable. Okay, so sigma or sigma x. So therefore, how we can write sigma x? Sigma x or sigma. So that will be positive square root of variance plus root over Vx. So sigma is the standard deviation. So what will be sigma squared? That will be V of x. That is, sigma squared is the variance. Sigma squared is the variance of the random variable. Sigma x is the variance of the random variable. Okay, so if we see the pictorial view, what is the meaning of this variance or standard deviation and mean? Okay. Let me draw this for you in a discrete case. Suppose along y-axis we are plotting the probabilities, and along x-axis we are plotting the values of capital X. Okay, suppose this is x0, x1, x2, x3, x4. So what will be the meaning of, let me draw the probability. Suppose this is the probability of x0, probability of x1, see, this is the probability of x1, suppose this is the probability of x2, probability of x3, and probability of, say, x4. Okay, now if we find the mean of this distribution, now see, from this picture, it's clear that this is x, and in this direction we are defining px, that is p of x0, p of x1, p of x, probability of x0, probability of x1, probability of x2, probability of x3. Now, if we look at this picture, it's very clear that probability mass is more concentrated about at the point x equal to 2. So if we find the mean of this distribution, it will indicate a point very close to it will indicate a point which is very close to the point x2, where the, that is, mean of the distribution will indicate that point where the probability mass is, indicate a point where the probability mass is more concentrated. Okay, so from, so here the probability mass is more concentrated. So if we find the mean of this distribution, it will get a, it will give you a point, it will indicate a point, or expected value, it will be indicate a point which is very close to the mean of the close to x2. Okay. And now if we find the variance, so what will be the variance? Suppose this is the mean of the distribution, mu. So if the variance is more, it will mean that the data are more spread about the mean if the sigma is more, and if sigma is less, it will give you some suppose this is the mean of the distribution, mu. It will mean that all the probability masses or probability masses are very close to the mean of the distribution. So here sigma is less, and here for this picture sigma is more. Okay, if sigma is less, that is the data are more concentrated towards the mean of the distribution, and if sigma is more, it will widely spread from its mean. Okay, that's the significance of mean and variance of a probability distribution. So let me try to solve a problem here. Let me first concentrate discrete distribution. So let the probability distribution is x is equal to I P of I, suppose the observations are minus 1, 0, 2, 1, 3, 4, and say the values are k, two k, four k, k and 2k. What we need to find? Find the value of k. Find the value of k and also find mean and variance of capital X. Also find mean and variance of capital X. So that this we want to find. Find the value of k and also find the mean and variance of the random variable capital X. So first let me try to find the value of the constant k. So how we can find the value of the constant k? How we can find the value of the constant k? We know for any probability distribution, sum of all the probabilities, sum of p of I must be is equal to 1. So that would give you I is taking the value minus 1, p of minus 1, p of 0, p of 1, then p of 3, p of 4, plus p of 3, p of 4, this equal to 1. So this is equal to, now let me put the values k, 2k, 4k. K plus 2k plus 4k plus k plus again 2k. So what we are getting? 3, 7, 8, 10. 10k is equal to 1. The value of k is coming to be 1 by 10. So if we put the value and so therefore the probability distribution of X is the capital X is P of x equal to I, P of I, x is equal to I, P of I, or you can write P of x I also, no problem, minus 1, 0, 1, 3, 4. So k is coming to be 1 by 10, so that will be 1 by 10, 2 by 10, 1 by 10, 2 by 10, that will be 4 by 10, Then what we'll get? Again, we'll get 1 by 10. Then we'll get 2 by 10. So that's the probability distribution of the random variable capital X. Probability distribution of the random variable capital X. Let us try to find probability distribution of the random. Now we need to find the expectation of X. Expectation of X. Now how to find expectation of X? Expectation of X is equal to XI P of XI. So that will be summation over I P of I. Now I, the different values of I and the corresponding probabilities. So minus 1 into probability of minus 1. 0 into P of 0 plus 1 into P of 1 plus 3 into P of 3 plus 4 into P of 4. So what we'll get? Minus 1 into 1 by 10, 0 into 2 by 10, plus 1 into 4 by 10, plus 3 into 1 by 10, plus 4 into 2 by 10. So if we simplify that, what will get? Minus 1 by, okay, 1 by 10 will be the LCM. What will get? Minus 1 plus 0 plus 4 plus 3 plus 8. So what we are getting? 12, 15, 15 minus 1, that is 14. 14 by 10, 1.4. So that's the mean of the distribution, that is 1 by 4. Now see, obviously from the table, it's very clear probability mass is more concentrated about the point 1. Now see, we're getting the variance, sorry, mean is 1 by 4, which is near to the point 1. Next, we'll see the variance of the distribution. We'll see how to find the variance of the distribution. V of X, what will be variance of X? We have already seen the formula to find variance. What is variance? Variance of X is expectation of X squared minus expectation of X whole squared. So what we'll get? Variance of X. This will be expectation of X squared minus expectation of X whole squared, expectation of X whole squared, expectation of X already we have found. So this will be expectation of X squared. So that will be summation over X, that will be X squared, that is I squared P of I, that is XI squared P of XI. So I'm directly writing I squared into P of I minus 1.4 squared. Now put the informations here. So minus 1 squared into P of minus 1 plus 0 squared into P of 0 plus 1 squared into P of 1 plus 3 squared into P of 3 plus 4 squared here 4 minus 1.4 squared. So let me put the informations. 1 squared is 1, 1 by 10, P of 0 is coming to be 2 by 10, 0 into 2 by 10 plus 1 squared is 1 into P of 1 is 4 by 10. Three will be 9 into again 1 by 10, 9 into 1 by 10 plus 16 into 2 by 10 minus 1.4 squared. So that would give you 10, what you'll get 1 plus 0 plus 4 plus 9 plus 32 minus 1.4 squared. So that would give you 46 by 10 minus 1.4 squared. 4.6 minus 1.4 squared. So try to find that. You will get 4.6 minus 1.4 squared.
2.64.
Okay. It's coming to be 2.64. So that's the variance. So what will be the standard deviation? Standard deviation, therefore, sigma x or sigma, that will be root over 2.64, root over
1.62.
So it's coming to be 1.62. So that is how to find the mean and standard deviation or variance of a random variable in discrete case. Now, similarly, we can find the mean and variance of a distribution in continuous case. So let us try to solve a problem related to continuous random variable. I'm taking a very simple example. The PDF means probability density function. The PDF of a random variable capital X is fx six x into 1 minus x, 0 less than or equal to x less than or equal to 1, 0 elsewhere. So that's the probability density function of a random variable capital X. What you need to find expectation of X and expectation of X squared. Find expectation of X and expectation of X squared. So let us try to solve this problem. Now, in continuous case, summation will be replaced by integration, as we know. So what will be expectation of x? The formula is integration minus infinity to infinity x into fx dx. Now the function, look at the function fx. Fx has the non-zero structure in between 0 to 1 only, otherwise the structure of the function is 0. So what will happen, that will be reduced to integration x varies from 0 to 1 x 6x 1 minus x dx, x into 6x into 1 minus x dx. So that is 6 is coming out, integration x runs from 0 to 1. If we multiply, what will get? X squared minus x cubed dx. Now let us integrate. X cubed by 3 minus x to the power 4 by 4. X varies from 0 to 1. So this will be 6. 1 by 3 minus 1 by 4, 6, 12, 4 minus 3, so it will give you 1 by 2. So that's the mean of the random variable capital X. Now we need to find the variance of the random variable capital X. So what will be the variance of the random variable capital X here? Variance of X, again variance of X, we know expectation of x squared minus expectation of x whole squared. So this equal to expectation of x squared, that will be again minus infinity to infinity x squared fx dx minus expectation of x whole squared. That will be 1 by 4. Since expectation of x we have calculated, that is 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 squared, that will be 1 by 4. So again, if we put the structure of fx, we'll end up with integration 0 to 1 x squared 6x 1 minus x dx minus 1 by 4. So this is equal to 6 integration x varies from 0 to 1, what will get? X cube minus x to the power 4 dx minus 1 by 4. 6, if we integrate, what will get? X to the power 4 by 4 minus x to the power 5 by 5 dx minus 1 by 4. So x varies from 0 to 1, 6. 1 by 4 minus 1 by 5, 1 by 4, 20 is the LCM, 5 minus 4, so 6 by 20, that will be 3 by 10 minus 1 by 4. If we simplify that, tell me what you'll get. what will be the simplification of this, please let me know. Zero point zero five. That's the variance of the distribution. So what will be the standard deviation? Although it's not asked to find. Okay, here I made a mistake here. That is not expectation of x squared. Find expectation of x and v of x, variance of x. Okay, not expectation of x squared. Okay. So what will be the standard deviation? Standard deviation will be root over vx. That is root over 0.05. So tell me the result.
Point two two three six.
Okay. So that's the standard deviation. Okay. So this is how to find the mean and variance in continuous case. Any difficulty is there, you can ask. Is it clear? Let us quickly solve another problem. Okay. Before solving this problem, let me define a function. So the gamma function is defined as gamma n is equal to integration 0 to infinity x to the power n minus 1 e to the power minus x dx. That's how to define gamma function. Gamma n is equal to integration 0 to infinity x to the power n minus 1 e to the power minus x dx. That's the definition of gamma function. Now, so some properties of gamma function here, n is real number, not necessarily integer, positive obviously. N is positive real. Okay. Now, there is a property of gamma function. Properties of gamma function are gamma n plus 1. This is equal to n gamma n. This is first property. Second is gamma half. The value of gamma half is root over pi. And the third property is gamma n plus 1. this is equal to factorial n if n is positive integer. Okay, so these are the properties of gamma function. Now let us try to solve a problem. Just remember these properties of gamma function. In the solution of the next problem, we will use these properties of gamma function. So first, what we'll take this problem, the PDF. Of a random variable capital X is fx is equal to x e to the power minus x, x greater than or equal to 0, 0, L square. So that's the probability distribution of a random variable capital X. What we need to find? We need to find expectation of X and variance of X. That what we need to find. Now let us try to find expectation of X, e of x by definition minus infinity to infinity x fx dx. So that will be integration x varies from 0 to infinity x e power minus x dx. Just we are putting the structure of fx. So what we are 0 to infinity x squared e to the power minus x dx. Now this integral 0 to infinity x squared e to the power minus x dx, I want to write this in this form. So that can be written as integration 0 to infinity x to the power 3 minus 1 e to the power minus x dx. Now x to the power 3 minus 1, x to the power n minus 1. So according to this law, that will be gamma 3. Gamma 3, that can be written as gamma 2 plus 1. Now if n is integer, but is gamma n plus 1, that is factorial n. So gamma 3 plus 2 plus 1, that will be factorial 2. So it's a factorial 2. Factorial 2 is 2. So that is expectation of X. Now let us try to find variance of X. So that will be expectation of X squared minus whole squared. So directly I'm writing 0 to infinity X squared X e to the power minus X dx. For so that would give you integration 0 to infinity x to the power 4 minus 1 e to the power minus x dx minus 4. So that is gamma 4 minus 4. Gamma 4 is factorial 3 minus 4. So that is 6 minus 4, that is 2. Okay, so that's the variance of the random variable capital X. So this is how to find the mean and variance of a random variable. Okay, so if any difficulty is there, you can ask.